In today's video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of psoas, and I will explain why you should be able to use psoas and why you need good flexibility. This is psoas. Okay, origin of psoas is lumbar spines. You don't need to memorize each specific number. Like, you don't have to remember which level of lumbar spines psoas originates. You don't have to. It's basically from lumbar spines. This is origin. Insertion is on femur. It's from lesser trochanter. But simply, you just remember it's from femur. It starts from lumbar spines and it attaches to femur. That means this muscle crosses hip joint. So basic function of psoas is that can move lumbar spines and hip joint. Let me explain hip joint first. This is profile view. By the way, understanding location of psoas is important. That is from lumbar spines, right? It's from like this, and it passes inside of the pelvis, then it attaches to femur. Remember, it's from very deep part of abdomen. It's from lumbar spines, okay? Then, when psoas contracts, the force of vector is like this. It's like going up. Then, what's gonna happen to your femur? It's brought to this way. What is the name of this movement? This is flexion. Flexion of hip. It's like running movement, right? You need good flexion for running and walking. Again, psoas is from lumbar spines. It goes inside part of pelvis and attaches to femur. When psoas contracts this way, that brings hip this way. That is hip flexion. Okay. Then, why is this movement so important? This is real person. This person's left hip is on flexion position. This is her trunk, and this is her left lower extremity. Her left hip is on flexion position, right? You got it? This is flexion, right? And her left hip is on flexion position. Now, her psoas is from deep part of abdomen, and like this. Her psoas keeps contracting in order to bring leg flexion position, hip flexion position. Psoas contracts this way, thus hip is going to flexion position. Thus, contraction of psoas is important for static position. Static means body is on same position. It's like yoga pose. Keep maintaining same position. That means static, right? Psoas is important for static position. And also that is important for mobility. It's important for movement. Like when you kick, when you do martial arts and you do leg kick, that is movement, right? That's mobility. Psoas is important both for static and movement. Again, psoas is from deep part of abdomen and running like this. When psoas contracts this way, hip joint is brought to hip flexion. That is important thing for contraction. Let's go back to basic anatomy again. I just explained function for hip. How about lumbar spines? Psoas is from lumbar spines. When psoas contracts this way, that brings core to flexion and also for extension. Flexion and extension. I am not talking about detailed biomechanics. Basically, it can do flexion and extension depends on your core position. It's going to be very complicated. To be simple, it can do flexion and extension. Thus, Let's see. This person's lumbar spine is in extension position. In order to get good length from core, the psoas needs good flexibility and contraction. And also, her psoas is maintaining good lumbar position. Psoas needs to contract for hip movement and lumbar movement. If you think about its anatomy, it's easy to analyze, right? Hip movement and lumbar movement. This is why you need good contraction of psoas for exercise, stretching, yoga, Pilates, ballet, dances, and athletic movement. This is very super important muscle. Now let me talk about why this muscle needs good flexibility. I have a question. What is function of psoas for hip? That is hip flexion. Hip flexion. This is contraction. When muscle contracts, that is shortening, right? Contraction means shortening of muscle. So, when you want to stretch your psoas, you do opposite movement. You bring leg this way. This is extension. Extension. Hip extension. So, in extended position of hip, let's see, your femur is now this position. Your psoas needs good stretching, like this. This pink is stretched psoas. And let's see, this purple is contracted psoas. You see, this length is much different, right? Hip extension gives good stretch for psoas. That makes sense. Then let's go to real person. Now, this person's left leg is on extension position of hip, right? By the way, this is flexion. Her left leg is on extension position. Where is her left psoas? It's from deep part of lumbar. It passes in pelvis and attaches to hip. See, this yellow is stretched psoas. In order to get good length on core and lower extremity, you need good flexibility of psoas. So her core looks very extended, good length. Okay? Again, you need good flexibility through core and psoas. And do you remember? Psoas can move lumbar spines. It can do both extension and flexion. So in order to move your lumbar spines, you need to be able to use psoas. Then, simultaneously, you want good flexibility for good healthy movement of lumbar spines. Does it make sense? For flexion, that is contraction. For extension, that is stretching. Interesting thing is you should be able to use for flexion and extension. That's such an important muscle. In today's video, I explained basic anatomy of psoas and I talked about why you need good contraction and good flexibility of psoas. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.